Another factor is diabetes. Now, all of you know, now India has become the world capital of diabetes. In 1995, 19.4 million patient population we were having with diabetes, and what is anticipated in 2025 is 57.2 million patient population. A huge population. That's a 140% increment. India has got a different rich heritage, different culture, different language, different ethnicity. We feel proud that India has got a rich culture, different heritage. But are we really proud to be Indian in this aspect? India, the diabetes capital of the world, which is really a shame on all of us. So, keep a check on your blood sugar. What's the normal? You should fasting from 60 to 100 milligram per cent. In the post meal, 91 to 140 milligram per cent. Now, quite frequently, when you see that camps are good, you know, then you random blood sugar. You may be going any time of the day. Now, especially if you have a meal in the last 2 hours, it is a random sugar, maybe little higher than even post meal. So random sugar up to 160 milligram per cent can be considered as normal. Another factor, which is a cholesterol. Now again, it is nothing but primarily from the diet, which is the key to health. It depends what we are supposed to eat and what do we eat. That is the most important factor. And you know, India has got different types of food. You may go to North India, go to South India, go to different parts, you will have different varieties of food. And you always feel like, oh, this is really good, this it's yummy, this is. But to what extent it is causing problem? Another risk factor, as mentioned, is the blood pressure. Now, what should be the blood pressure? Now, as per the new guidelines, you know, earlier I used to say, if you are 120, 80, it's fine, but now your normal blood pressure should be less than 120, 80. If you are 120 by 80, you are already borderline or pre-hypertensive or hypertensive. So that is a condition which you need to be careful. So borderline is 120 to 139 and 80 to 89 in diastolic. Hypertension, if you are 140 by 90 and above, you are already labeled as hypertension. So lower the blood pressure, it is better. Now how do we change this lifestyle? The fundamental determinants of lifestyle, it is mentioned in Shushusha, Ahar, Vyohar, Vichar and Achar. These are the four basic things which needs to be changed. Ahar is nothing but nutrition, what we eat. Vyohar is behavior. How is our behavior towards different situations? Vichar is thinking, positive thinking versus negative thinking. Again, a lot of impact. And Achar is conduct. So these are the four different parameters. Now for which, now as I mentioned, for metabolic syndrome, which comprises of different aspects, what we need to do is control the obesity. And obesity management is very simple, but very difficult. Daily physical activity, and you need to moderate your food intake. In terms of fruits, oil, meat and beans, vegetables, grains, you need to plan out and take it in the right proportion. Now the drugs have come. You might be aware of, like you have drugs for diabetes, drugs for blood pressure, there are drugs for obesity, which are called anti-obesity drugs, and which accounted for sales of nearly $500 million in global markets. It has already come to India. And if you go to a doctor and you say you are obese, they will check your BMI, which is about 27, they will recommend you anti-obesity drugs. The overall sales of anti-obesity drugs is projected to triple by 2010. You can imagine, it's going to go up. And what will happen? Probably the government will have a currency like this, and because it's a huge, huge amount which is involved in that. Now, healthy living to conquer stress. So you need to have your lifestyle which is to be modified to conquer all your diseases and the stress. Examine your diet, lower your salt intake, which is very important. Lower your intake of refined sugars and carbohydrates, all these grated grains, malt grains. Lower your caffeine intake. Yeah, but again, you know, this caffeine is predominantly higher proportion in the coffee. The tea is good, and especially if you have a green teas. So that is very, very good. But usually, our Indian tradition of making teas, then you put a lot of milk, then there is a lot of sugar, and then all these beneficial effects go over. But if you have a real black tea,
the
green tea which is available, which it's available as a grass. What do you call that?
You go to Asia or Germany? You go to Germany.
So the best thing is to have a tea without milk, without sugar. But we Indians, we know how do we eat it. And what you need to add to your diet is vegetables. Every day, at least minimum 100 grams of fruits and vegetables consumption is absolutely mandatory. So complex carbohydrates, vitamins, what? Now carbohydrates, like if you are learning of fruits, fruits are not bad. You are going to get carbohydrates from them. So that is you can add. But if you are having carbohydrates in the form of cold drinks, that is bad. Of course, vitamins and water, you need to take in adequate amount. Symptoms for low BP. Again, so having a low BP just because you said that you've gone to a doctor and he has checked and his BP is 110/70, if you don't have complaints, it's absolutely fine. Even if it is 100/60, patient doesn't have, or the person, not patient, the person doesn't have symptoms, it's absolutely fine. If the person feels giddy or feels blackout while standing, that is the person's symptom, then you otherwise. Chest pain. Not necessary. So it is mentioned in Yajurveda, oh God, give us food which does not cause any disease and also gives us strength. Mahabharata also is mentioned, he who takes food in proper measure lives a long life and lives without disease, gets strength and alertness of mind. But this is all we listen. Finally it becomes yao. It's really yummy. So this is what the reality is. This should be your picture and not the previous one. But tell me, given a chance, what you will prefer? I'm sure in both the things. We had this, one of the best meetings of in Vienna about a diet and health, diet and diseases. And there were top nutritionists who were there. And after there was a desert lecture kept. On one side there was a fruit platter was there. One side of various pastries and things. And all the nutritionists, there was a queue in taking that line, but nobody was there for the food. That's what the ground reality. Okay, so if you are aware of this nutritional chart, I will not go into the detail of it. So, healthy day, you need to have a rest, get a minimum of 6 hours of continuous rest. That's most more important because I mentioned is continuous. Because I had one patient who says, my doctor told me that you require 6 hours of sleep. So I'm taking it. Then I learned that he says 3 hours I take it at night because he was doing shift duty. 3 o'clock his duty was getting over. He used to come on 4 o'clock, go to bed, get up at 8 o'clock, and then again sleep 2-3 hours in the afternoon. So that is not a problem. When you say proper rest, it is 6 hours of continuous rest. Exercise at least 20 minutes 5 times a week. That is the bare minimum. That is if you don't have any illness. That is if you don't have any illness. If you have any component, obviously it goes on increasing. But this is the bare minimum for all of us. Break a sweat to release endorphins. So that's very important. You should sweat out. And that will release endorphins, which are good for that. So exercise is very good. Now, people ask, what is the best exercise? Walking. Nothing else. Even walking. Go for a walk. It reduces strength. Strengthens the heart. It strengthens the muscles, improves the blood circulation, helps quit smoking. This is very important. Now, people who want to really quit smoking, ask them to go for a regular walk, and automatically it will help in quitting smoking. It massages the leg, reduces the cholesterol, it modulates the cardiac stamina. So walking is the best exercise. This is a picture of World Trade Center, Chicago. Now if you see the first floor, how many steps are there? People are ready to wait in the queue to going up. But nobody wants to use the staircase. That's the ground reality. Now, somebody, I can see when coming down, people want to use the same elevator. They don't want to go, they don't want to use the staircase. So, again, learn to manage your anger. Because, again, when you are angry, what happens? You are putting unnecessary adrenaline into your circulation, which will cause. cause rise in blood pressure, which will also cause increased chance of heart attack. And that affects your health, and it causes you to overreact to many situations. And so often, it is that particular situation you are going to spoil in terms of relation, of any such matters. So that is very, very important.